But let the team think outside the box on how they're going to get the appointment. Because you might have one person that gets appointments easily out of their service drive, and then you have another person that gets more appointments out of referrals, and then another person that gets more appointments through social media. The goal is, however you want to get there, is to get one appointment a day. Activity. So this is what you measure when you're not getting those appointments. So if you're trying to figure out, okay, how much activity is needed to generate one appointment, it's right there in your CRM. So we can pull up your CRM right there with you, look at your data from the last 90 days, as long as everybody's been logging 100% of their efforts. Because if we're not logging 100%, it's not gonna work. So you have to log all your data, you know, good data in, then you get good results out of it. If it's bad data, then it's gonna be hard. So make sure you're logging 100% of your efforts. But imagine, just like in sports, if a baseball player is keeping up with how many times at bat versus how many times there's a bunt, how many times he's hitting a home run, how many times it's going to left field, middle field. When you're measuring that data, now you know where you need to grow. You know where you're off a little bit or what you need to do to improve. Or if you're successful hitting bats or in this place setting appointments, you're going to know what you need to do. Is it how many texts, how many emails, how many videos, how many appointments? Basic stuff, but that's what this message is encouraging everybody to do, is to make sure that we're being brilliant at the basics. Because whenever you're starting over, it's like half the year we're starting up. Be brilliant at the basics. Next, monthly goals. Make sure they're broken down weekly. So again, if your store, we're trying to sell 200 cars a month, 100 cars a month, that's 25 a week. Okay, 25 a week is 5 a day. Okay, what does that look like from everybody? Again, what's the activity look like? Who needs to sell those cars? If you're an individual watching this, same thing. You want to sell 20 cars a month. That's too big of a number to just be thinking of. So then you got to break that down. 4 weeks, that's 5. All right, that's 5 cars sold a week. So then if we're doing that, that's pretty much 1 car a day. So if 2 days go by and you hadn't sold a car, by that third day, you need to be hunting 3 or 4 car deals. And manage that every single week. And if you get behind 1 week, then what you want to do is make sure you pick it up the following week. But the goal is, the rest of this year, we have no bad weeks, right? You know, you can still have a good month with 1 bad week. But if you have 2 bad weeks in 1 month, your month's going to look a little tough. If you have 3 bad weeks, we've all been there, right? You know, 3 bad weeks and you think you're going to make it up in that last week, miserable, all right? Excuse me, social media strategy for the team. Make sure you're posting daily as a company and then also individuals. Again, these posts need to be more about solving problems, not just about cars. So 70 to 80% of the posts that we put out on social media really need to be about engaging with clients and customers and sharing, you know, different things like the fuel economy on certain vehicles and maybe that arrive, because that kind of solves a problem, right? Because gas is driving that narrative. But just be thinking, you know, customer testimonials, video testimonials, pictures, things that draw attention to your brand and make people feel good, or it helps people the next time they're going to buy a car. 100% of your customers get logged. This could be one area that this is all you focus on, is getting back to the basics of every customer that shows up on the lot gets logged, and every phone up, 100% of those get logged. I see not the walk-in part, and plus I'm not watching that, I'm not sitting at your showroom, but on the phone up, I can literally pull up anybody's CRM and look at how many walk-ins and internet leads they have and phone, and I will be able to tell you without a doubt if you're missing phone ups or not. Because if your phone up number is smaller than your walk-in and your internet, there's a good chance that your team, whoever's taking those calls, is not logging them. It should be internet leads should probably be your biggest number. Phone should be your next. Walk-in, people that just walk in, should be the third. Unless you're in some crazy metro where people are just getting dropped off by the busloads to your dealership. If that's still happening, hats off to you. But the majority of dealerships, the bulk of their opportunities comes in from internet, phone, then walk in. Next, communicate to your team daily with data. Listen for feedback. And all this is saying is just make sure that all this stuff sounds good, but whatever thing that you pick that you're gonna really focus in on with your team, be sure to make sure that you're sharing that with your team. Make sure you're communicating that information every single day. I can barely read this quote because my video thing keeps covering stuff up. But what my quote here, it says, what's one thing you really wanted to do in the first half of the year that you put on the back burner? So I'll say it again. What's one thing you really wanted to do in the first half of the year that got put on the back burner? So that's more for you. And like, I've got my things, but just be thinking, okay, first half, did you maybe not do social media? Did you maybe not use your CRM like you're supposed to? Did you stay away from the service drive? Did you not get engaged with the community? Did you not sell your referrals and get some repeat business? Think of just one thing again that you didn't do in the first half that you know that you still have time to do in the second half and master that thing, and it can change your whole life and your whole career. It's never too late. Okay, so inventory acquisition. I put this slide on here because to me, this is a crucial element of a dealership's business, especially if you're a franchise. So if you're a franchise dealer watching this, your inventory acquisition strategy is probably one of the most important decisions for you and your team. And even if you're an individual, you should be doing this as well, which is buying vehicles from the public. And there's three different ways that I have on here. Private party purchase, one of the easiest ways is to go ahead and do that through social media. You can go to Facebook Marketplace. You can also go to Craigslist, use platforms like that. But you can engage with people and ask and see if they're open to selling your vehicle or setting up a call. Now, it's very similar to internet leads. If you reach out to three people and ask if you can buy their car, you're interested, odds are not all three are gonna do it. Maybe, that'd be great. So it's a volume game. So you gotta message people like 1 to 5 times per day. If you can do more, that's even better. But keep working that funnel, you know, like, so you have to go through Messenger, you have to go through Facebook Marketplace, you have to do through Craigslist. There's so many different places, but just know that it's a volume game. So you might have to go through 100 people, ask them if they'd be interested to get 10 or 20 cars. Well, ask any used car manager that's sitting here watching this, if they are, ask them how many vehicles they have to go through. They scan at auction before they buy a car. Odds are, if they're somebody that's really good at buying vehicles, they probably scan through a lot of inventory before they buy one. So again, utilizing your time, your brand, this is a great way to acquire inventory. Number two, the service lane, which is easy because it's people coming right to the store, but it amazes me how many stores still don't have a service lane strategy. And the best way that I can advise everybody here is to get one or two people that are actually encouraged, or this is what they want to do, or either we hire somebody and I'll help you set that thing up however you want to, where we can work that service lane, because it comes down to communication, having a process, but making sure that our people are trained for it. And next, one of the easiest ways also is through your CRM. So we can do video campaigns. As you guys know, I'm on video now, but video campaigns talking about what inventory that you're looking for. We can communicate that out to your database. We can put in a trade-in link, and that's an easy way to generate leads, especially to active shoppers that haven't made a decision yet. And then of course, going to people that have bought from you 18 to 24 months, 36 months. Think about, be strategic, you know? So with our CRM, the managers, what we can do is we can actually, okay, what kind of cars do we need? Okay, we need SUVs that are priced under a certain amount. We need mileage under a certain amount, and it gets a certain amount of fuel economy. Well, we can get in the CRM and find all those people and communicate a message right to them and just say, hey, do you know that your vehicle's appreciated over the last 90 days due to the current market? Boom, rest is there. Forgive me about the picture. I don't know. Like, so I use a software for the PowerPoint presentation. I don't know why the active fitness person is okay. I wish I could edit this out. I'm not going to, but don't make fun. If you're watching this now, I'm just saying, I don't know why I have a lady that's working out on a slide that says social media, but we're just going to use it and just say, who's your audience? And maybe she's your audience. But anyway,